Another hint that God create God. You know the question. Sometimes children ask, "Who create God?" It's a difficult question because you explain that it cannot be that anything exists by himself. It must to be somebody that create all this.
It must be Pado.
All right. So God create everything. All right. Now I ask another question: who create God? All right. So. The answer for who created God is God create himself. All right? So in the world of Kabbalah it's called Nitzotz Katan Bore, a small spark of creator that become a small spark create. Nitzotz Katan Bore shenia Nitzotz Katan Nivra. All right, it is a small spark of the creator that become a small spark created. All right, so it's like to create, it means to take something out of yourself, to take yourself out of yourself.
Bar is something bar out.
Bar, it means out.
Out.
It means sun, it means out too.
Take something out of you.
When we talk about Avraham, the secret of the stone, it starts with the letter Av, but the two other letters is Bar, what it means son. So it is a father and his son as well. The principle of stone that we talk about this all the time. And with the man, you have a mother too. After he received the hay, he became Abraham. For this super wisdom that is too high can be understood and revealed to in this world, can be realized in this world, he receives the hay. Alright, so another hint about Bereshit that create Elohim. Bereshit is Barati. I create the letter Shin. Barati. I create Shin, the letter Shin. Shin is the letter that corresponds to Yitzhak, to the Mashiach, like we explained many times. The 21 letters correspond to the concept of the name of Ekiyeh. That equal 21. I shall be who I shall be. I am going to be born. I didn't born yet.
Say that in Hebrew.
Ehye asher ehye. Usually we say ekye. Do not pronounce the. It's the name of God. So Shin, that corresponds to Yitzhak, is the 21 generation too. Parad Yitzhak, the fear of Yitzhak equal 300 equal Shin. But equal Ruach Elohim, the spirit of God, that our sages said that the spirit of God is the Ruach Elohim is the spirit of Mashiach. Alright, so Barat Ishin, it's like I create the Mashiach too. Just in the first word of Bereshit. Alright? And Shin equal Elohim with all the feeling letter in the full potential of, you know, milu yudin, the maximum milu, the way we use all the time the miluim. So it means aleph, lamed, hey, yud, and mem. Elohim. With all the feeling letter equal 300. So I create God. This is the first word of the creation.
So also Messiah is part of the Bereshit.
And this God that God create is the soul of Mashiach. The secret of the soul of Mashiach that everybody have it.
Which is Yeshua, it's the soul of Messiah. Actually.
Yeshua represents this aspect. Every Jew have this spark that is this Shin that is Yitzhak, Avinu, etc.
It's a Yehida as well.
What?
Yehida.
is correspond to the Yechida too. Alright? So Yitzchak, we call him Bincha Yechidcha, your only son. Alright, so like we say many times, if we explain the thing in the right way, we can, it seems like we say exactly the same thing like the Christians say, but still, how they say it, it's not kosher yet.
Too much light.
It's not kosher because no. Because they don't see it.
The kelim.
They don't see it, first of all, in vessel of explanation, and they don't understand that this is belong to anybody. In the moment, it don't belong to anybody. You can say it belong to nobody or to everybody.
God is right. God has no religion.
All right. So in the moment you understand that Elohim Atem, you are all God, is no problem. Like Yeshua said, when they accuse him that he make himself God, he said, "You are all God." All right, so we understand you are all God, no problem. All right, so I just give example that things just have to be explained in a way that you can get to this world with no damage. So we have this, how you say, nuscha,
formula
that 15 times 58 plus 43 equal Bereshit. Now, what will happen in instead of 58, we'll put here another number. Let's try to put the more important number, name of God, etc. Instead of 58, we'll see what we got here in this formula. Alright, so if I do, start with 1. 50 times 1 plus 43 equal chen. 58, it's an important number. If I put here 2, 15 times 2, the bet of Bereshit, plus 43, 2 wisdom equal Chochmah, 73. Important number. We have here 2 times Yud Kei. So the wisdom is to understand that there are 2 wisdom. After we talk more about these 2 kind of wisdom.
It's like the plus and minus coming out of nothing. Yesh Me'ayin coming out of there's something out of nothing.
Well, we say that in the creation, in the moment, if we say that everything is zero, so everything we draw, it must to have 2 direction. Alright, so this one of the meaning of 2 beginning. Everything has to start with 2 beginning.
Matter and antimatter, it's everything plus
yes.
and minus.
Yes, it's like plus
comes
and minus.
Coming from nothing.
Yes. Now, this is Yud-Kei, this is the 2 first letter of the name of God. Let's put here the 2 second letter of the name of God. Vav-Kei is at equal 11. 50 times 11 plus 43. Let me see how much it is. This is Yitzchak. Yitzchak. This was 73. This is 208. It's important. We have Chen already. Now we have Yitzchak, we have wisdom. Now, let's put all the name of God. 50 times No, before the name of God, we have 21. It's the number, the name of I shall be. It's the name of God that equal 21 plus 43 equal probably Mashiach.
Ekiyeh,
it's the name of God, the name of I shall be. Ehyeh. We don't pronounce it. Alright? I shall be. Yud K time I shall be, it's like father and mother, plus 43 equal Mashiach. So we have Chen, Yitzchak and Mashiach already, the three main things that all our book is based on it. Alright, so we definitely find an important formula. Now let's put 26, the name of God, the regular name of God that equal 26. 15 times 26 plus 43 equal 43 Mashiach Kohen. What is 433? Chen. If I do Mashiach in all the four gematria, Mashiach in regular number equal 358. In order number equal 52. What is Eliyahu? In a small number equal 16. In a final small number equal 7. These three numbers equal Kohen. So when I talk about this number 443, it's like Mashiach in all the four types of Gematria together. That three of them is the secret of the priest. Alright, so it's the King Mashiach and it's the priest together. It's from this Gematria of Mashiach plus Kohen, Mashiach Kohen. In the Torah, the priest called a Kohen a Mashiach. The priest Mashiach. Okay, after this name, we have another name, 31, it's the name of God too.
Which one?
El, the name of God. 50 times. 31 plus 43 equal 508. That is Yitzchak, son of Avraham. That is Avraham, son of Yitzchak. That equal 2 times donkey. 508. It's very important. It's number. It's a number that we can give a lesson just about this number. 508, it's like Chen, 58, 508, and it represents Yitzchak, son of Avraham, or Avraham, son of Yitzchak, that have the acronym of Avi, my father. So, when Esav say, Gamani Avi, Avi, it's the acronym of Avraham ben Yitzchak. Okay, Avraham. Aleph, Ben, Bet, Yitzchak, Yud, make the word Avi, my father. So I am too Avraham, son of Yitzchak.
It's vice versa.
Gamani Chamor, I am donkey too, equal Mashiach. Alright, we talk about this Gam, I am too. Alright, so there are many nice things with this number. What else we have with here? Let's put this word we talk about, boom, that is the beginning, the end, and the middle of the Torah, what is 38. 15 times 38, what's the beginning, the end of the Torah, the three letters that equal bull.
And what is the meaning?
Bull, it means exactly in the middle. Uh-huh. Bull clear, bull. Why?
Straight.
It's just there, you know? It's bull.
Straight into the middle, yeah.
Straight in the middle, it's today the way we use the word bull, but this was, like we said before, this was another name of the month of Cheshvan. We call it Chodesh Bull. Have to do with the Mabul, with the flood.
Flood.
Okay, this is a basic month that has to do with Mashiach and with the building of the third temple. It all has to do with the month of Cheshvan in the future. So this plus 43 equal Taryag, 613, what is all the commandment we have, right? So
mitzvot.
So we see that we have a very messianic formula that has to do with this word Bereshit, this number 913, from what he made. How exactly this 913, what kind of construction we can make with this number, all right? So probably there are infinite things about this, but one of the nice things is to split it to his final middle point and to reveal this kind of formula with always the heading Me too, two, right?
It's something about ego, me too, I'm part of it. Who says me too?
Well, Gam, we say that is She'erit. She'erit is somebody that makes from himself nothing. I'm just a She'erit, I'm just something left.
Leftover.
I'm just leftover. Reshit, it's like I would say, well, I'm the first one. Mm. Sherit, I'm nothing.
Ah, it's both.
So we can say that about the wisdom, there are two sides of the concept of the wisdom. It is a concept of being the first one, like Avram calls the first, and it is a concept of being nothing.
Humble.
Bitul.
Annulled.
The word for wisdom, the inner world of wisdom, it means bitul, it means litbatel, it means to be nothing. It means I'm completely have no consciousness of myself. Alright? It's bitul. There are different words that are similar to this meaning of bitul. In wisdom, to be nothing, it's called bitul. In the mother, in the bina, to be nothing, it means humble, anava. In the Vav, that represents the Midot, the to be nothing is Achna'a, submission. In Malchut, to be nothing, you call it Shiflut. Shiflut, it means I'm very low. It means I have ego, I have a big ego, unfortunately, but I all the time sacrifice my ego to God with a prayer. I am nothing. It's not that I am not aware of myself. This is a kingdom, this is the bottom line. Alright, so it's like there are many words that correspond to be nothing, but the one that corresponds to the wisdom is bitul. Alright, it means, like we say that Chokhmah is a power, of what? Like it's two opposite things. Power, it's like something very active, you know, it's like it's to be something. I am strong, power. Ma, it means I am nothing. Ma, what? Like Moshe says, Vanachnu ma, what we are. Right? Alright, so the main idea here is that we have two kind of wisdom. One wisdom has to do with being the first, like Avraham Avinu. And the second wisdom has to do